reading from the letter of St. Paul to Romans, chapter 8, verses 31 to 39. What shall we say after this? If God is with us, who shall be against us? God, who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how could he withhold from us all things along with him? If God puts right with him those he chooses, who can accuse them? Who will dare to condemn? It is Christ himself who died for us, who was raised from the dead and is seated at the right hand of God, interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Will it be trials, or anguish, or persecution, or hunger, or lack of clothing, or dangers, or sword? As Scripture says, for your sake we are being killed all day long. They treat us like sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all of this we are more than conquerors through him who has loved us. I am certain that neither death nor life, neither angels nor spiritual powers, neither the present nor the future, nor cosmic powers, neither the world above nor the world below, nor any creatures whatsoever will be able to separate us from the love of God which we have in Jesus Christ our Lord. Word of the Lord.
एक ही बात कहना है, हम लोग अभी शहीद तिरंगा खटिया के सामने खड़े हैं, बहुत बड़े वीर थे, लेकिन अपनी जान न्योछावर दिए ताकि झारखंड आदिवासी जनता एक जनता बने रहे। कहा जाता है कि शहीदों का खून कभी बेकार नहीं बनता, शहीदों का खून कभी बेकार नहीं बनता, इसलिए हम लोग हमारे शहीदों के खून को देखे हैं, उन्हीं से हम लोग अब तक जिंदे हैं, इसलिए हम लोगों को खुद शहीद बनने के लिए भी तैयार होना चाहिए, तभी हम सब अपनी झारखंड, अपना स्वप्न का झारखंड को हम लोग पता लगा सकेंगे। अब सबों को जोहार जोहार
Johar. On behalf of the Madhya Pradesh province of the Society of Jesus and its members, I pay homage and offer tribute to Father Stan Swami, a prophet, a hero, a champion, and a martyr of the marginalized. Truly, Father Stan Swami was a hero and a champion of the rights and dignity of the tribals of Jharkhand and the neighboring states. He dedicated his entire life for the emancipation of the underprivileged and the marginalized. He was a silent but fearless campaigner for tribal rights and tribal upliftment. Father Stan Swami worked on various issues of Adivasi communities, such as on the issues of land, forest, and labor rights. First, he voiced for the full and proper implementation of the fifth schedule of the Constitution, which stipulated setting up of a tribal advisory council, whose members will be solely from the Adivasi community for their protection, well-being, and development. Second, he challenged the indiscriminate arrest of thousands of young Adivasis falsely labeled as Naxals. He filed a public interest petition in the High Court of Jharkhand for their release. Third, he opposed the setting up of land banks, which would deprive the tribals from their community land and forest in favor of industries and mining. Fourth, he opposed the displacement of tribals in the name of one-sided development. Through these works, Father Stan Swami always defended the rights and dignity of the tribals. He will always be remembered for these contributions and for his commitment to tribal cause. He was a peaceful man and always looked for peaceful settlement of the problems, following the path of justice, peace, and reconciliation. His final days and months were very painful. They will remind us of many things that are horribly wrong with our governance and justice system. On the grounds of his age and deteriorating health, he moved the court repeatedly with bail petitions, but the court remained deaf to his plea. He was denied of even minimum facility like simple sipper and straw to drink water. Today, Father Stan Swamy is not with us physically, but his legacies will keep him alive for decades and centuries. With his death, he is sown into the ground, but he will rise in the form of his followers who will carry forward his unfinished works. May God reward him with an eternal life, and may his soul rest in peace.
Suhar, Jal, Jungle, Jameen is synonym to tribal cultural identity, and Father Stan Swamy was fully in it. Jal, Jungle, Jameen, apart from being lifelines of tribals, they unfold and teach us mysteries of life. Take example of trees in the jungle. Among shrubs and bushes, innumerous trees find and create space for their growth. Rooted deep, these trees grow in full stature, unshaken, and yield benefits to anyone who comes to them. Imagine of a banyan tree, apart from being home and source of food for birds, animals, its shade provides peace and solace to those who find its shelter. Stan's life, hailing from Trichy, Tamil Nadu, joining Jesuits, coming to Chaibasa, Jharkhand, working for the poor and marginalized, tribals, Dalits, and other vulnerable groups, his higher studies in Manila and Belgium, working in different capacities, ISI Bangalore, Johar in Chaibasa, and as founding father in Bagaicha, all are part of the story, like becoming of a tree in the jungle. He created space for himself to grow, deep rooting in spirituality, growing fully humane, unshaken by odds and challenges. Stan's life unfolds many facets of human life to be learned and taken inspiration. Elders in tribal society are respectable as banyan tree. Under its shade, the tribal society finds shelter, peace, and solace. The children play, enjoy, and grow healthy. Shade of a banyan tree is a symbol of prosperity among tribals. Father Stan Swamy, though not a tribal, but very much a tribal with his mind, work, and spirit, from the day he started living the tribal life and working for Jal, Jungle, Jameen. In this endeavor, he was one among the respectful elders in tribal society. He taught scientific approach to social activism. Through his work, he touched the life of many, and outpouring condolence, prayers, candlelights, protests, rallies, posters, and banners are spontaneous homage to his life sacrifice. He created ambience in Bagaicha with tribal philosophy. Bagaicha, shade of grove under which tribals hold their panchayat and reach to consensus. The building structures are tribally. Pathalgadi, on which the names of the tribal martyrs are written for taking inspiration. Akhara, place of cultural expression. Sarna, the sacred grove of tribals and statue of Bir Birsa Munda, instilling Kranti for tribal identity. Jal, Jungle, Jameen. These he lived in his life and shared the same with all who sought his company in living a life of struggle for social justice. As an icon, he continues to inspire us, the tribals, Dalits, and all who stand with values. He, Father Stan, stood.
A gallant salute to Father Stan Swamy SJ. He was a man of deep spirituality, not in the traditional sense, but rooted in Ignatian spirituality, that is finding God in everything. Often I saw him praying to God of the creator of the universe, that is, praying to God and with the nature, praying to the tribal heroes and martyrs for the Pathalgadi, that is, a stone erected and names of tribal fighters and martyrs inscribed. As for the tribal culture, through prayer he was drawing inspiration and strength to fight against injustice. Father George Pateri, the former Posa, says, "What affects life is spirituality." Father Stein was deeply affected by the life of marginalized, and especially of tribals, and gave his life for their causes. Physically, he was old, yet I saw him attending many padyatras and rallies against displacement. He was a real tribal, for he deeply understood the value of Jal, Jangal, Jameen in tribal life and worldview. Jal, Jangal, Jameen are the sources of tribal livelihood and identity. I heard him in every meeting at Bagaicha Ranchi speaking against land grabbing for corporates in the name of land buying. He raised the issue of under trial prisoners. Most of them are tribals and Dalits. He became the voice of voiceless for violation of rights of tribals and Dalits, which threatened the government. And so he was put behind the bars and lost his life there, lacking medical care. It is not mere death, but a judicial death. Father Stein is no more with us, but his spirit will be with us, and especially with the tribals, for guiding and inspiring to fight against dehumanizing forces in bringing justice and peace.